It's nothing, okay? It's just a place for people to talk about their problems.
I know this is an unpopular topic among incels, and incels don't really like to hear this. They always cope by saying, you know, women are attracted to dumb men. Women are attracted to, you know, low IQ men. I mean, it is just one of the copes that incels love to clinch on. She knew all women would reject him. She knew he is not made of good genetic material. Had a feeling this was gonna happen, so I felt sore for him and kept my light on even if I am not attracted to him. Oh man, this is such a fucking beatdown.
Can you imagine the shit we would get from normies if you acted like him? Everybody would tell us, oh, you have childish hobbies, this is why you are incel. Woman like mature man, blah blah blah, and other generic normie bullshit.
I know normies in the comment section are gonna say, well, that is because America is a racist. Here in Europe, we eat black dick for breakfast, we are so liberal. I don't know how many times I have to talk about race spill in this channel, but I still get messages from people asking me to rate them. Like, they say, hey, I am an Indian guy, can you give me a rating? And I am like, the fuck you mean rate me? You said you are Indian, right? Say no more. Say no fucking more, bro. Like, I don't want to say it is over, but it is over. If you ever find yourself in incel circles asking people to rate you, then you know what the deal is.
I know in the comment section people are gonna say shit like, I know an Indian guy who slays. And I agree, there are some Indian slayers out there.
In the past, I have known some incels who managed to find a girlfriend, and they all did 180 on their views on women. Oh dude, my girl ain't like that. And then a couple months later, same guys tried to come back. Bro, I got cheated on, you guys were right. Like, of course we were right.
Now, beyond those, oh my god, incel TV, you are so racist, you are so evil. Then there was the cop coming from black men saying, all black women are so loyal to black men, unlike your white horse sisters, or black queens are so loyal.
But they still think, oh, it's all God's plan, man. He's testing you. He's testing you by giving you a shit life. If God is testing me, then he should set lower standards for me.
Hannah says, why are you doing this? Material things don't matter. If you are born for eternity in hell, that's it. You don't get a second chance. Please reconsider this, Brandon. And Oreo Man says, bitch, fuck you.
Boomers can't understand. They just can't. They just can't get it. Their time was different. This is why you see boomers say shit like, oh, son, why won't you go to a girl and ask her out? You just gotta be confident. Their time was different. Oh, back in my day, I worked for a summer and bought my first house.
So many times I hear shit like, if he was running bad boy game, he would have gotten some girls. Oh, you are black. Just thug mix, bro. Just commit crimes, bro. I also love how they are always using the clickbait hyperbole titles. Do this and never get rejected again. The dark secret to make any woman fall in love with you. These secrets are so deep, so dark, even they haven't figured them out yet.
Hey, I am an Asian install just like Elliot. Can I be your pet, please?
How cute is that, bro? Maybe you're gonna get a pat on the back.
Then we are getting told, you know, well, we don't owe you anything. You are not owed anything in this life.
What I am talking about on this channel have empirical evidence backing them up, so I don't really pay attention to people who say, oh man, you know, the beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Let me show you this guy, this ugly guy who has a girlfriend. Like, people who try to deny black pill, they got nothing, and they know they got nothing.
So whenever we talk about the black pill, we always get told Tinder isn't real life, or online dating doesn't reflect reality. Boomers don't get it. Their time was just different. They just don't get it. It is real life. It is real life now. If you were to ask her, she would 100% say, oh my god, you guys are so wrong. You black pill guys are so wrong. I am actually attracted to 5'4 Indian men. I am actually attracted to bolder guys. Racism is evil, guys. 100% she would say some bullshit like that. One time I was told, you know what, man? This study has 5,000 women sample size, but in the world there are 4 billion women. Guys, I am not kidding. This is their intelligence and education level. I am not bullshitting. These are the responses I am getting. Some guys were saying, oh man, you know, I don't think Elliot Roger was ugly, man. You know, Ted Bundy isn't really better looking than him. Your opinion doesn't mean anything. What matters is female's opinion. The other day I was told, why are you even making these videos as if you discovered something new? And he wasn't saying it in a good manner. He was talking trash, but I was like, you are completely right. Another beauty. Black pill is wrong because I am an ugly guy who had a girlfriend once. You believe in this shit because you are an incel. I don't believe in black pill because I am an incel. I grudgingly acknowledge the black pill. Some normies are saying, just be white is wrong because I am an ethnic guy and I had a GF 20 years ago, some shit like that. Dude, I just made a 30 minutes video talking with studies, stats, like, you know, evidence. Black pill is wrong because I have a girlfriend and you don't. Oh bro, it is time to show off our social dominance, bro. We are so alpha, bro. This is why they will always say, oh, you know, I like the way he is, his personality, not because he's 6'3 white guy. Oh, I am different, you know. It is not because he's white, he just happens to be white. Oh, my case is different, you know? It is other Asians that are white worshippers. But when you ask the other person, she will also say, oh, it is not me, it is others. Okay, it is not you, it is not her. Then how do you explain these numbers? But of course, if you asked her, she will say, oh, him being white has nothing to do with it. White washed out, Black Lives Matter. And all that generic virtue signaling stuff that she doesn't even give two shits about. Oh, you have high standards, that is why you're incel. Meanwhile, they know that it is them who have unrealistic and sky-high standards. It is women that are demanding men that are much better than themselves. Oh, you incels are superficial, when it is them who are shallow and superficial. Oh, you think we have nothing to offer other than our bodies. I have heard this phrase much more from normie females than I have heard from incels. You think that about yourself and then project your insecurity onto us. Projection comes in. Oh, you are racist. No, I am just pointing out your behavior. I am not approving it. Again, gaslighting comes in.
It is like a 6'4 guy saying, oh, it doesn't matter, you know, I am 6'4 and I am still single. Oh, race doesn't matter, you know, just white is nonsense. I am white and I still can't get anything. At that point, you are not any different than the normies who say, I am ugly and I have a partner. Looks aren't that important, bro. Oh, race doesn't matter, you know, I know this guy, I know this ethnic guy, and he has a smoking hot girlfriend. Like, how are you any different than those normies, bro? Oh, white females are just victims of feminism, bro. Look at this based white girl who voted Trump, bro. Similarly, you have ethnics who say, oh, our Muslim women aren't like that, man. You know, they are not like white females. They are different. These guys aren't even red-pilled, let alone black-pilled.
Oh, our women aren't like that, man. They would never dish us in favor of white chat. They don't understand the female nature. There is straight-up cop right there. Similar with right-wing nationalist incels who believe their innocent white angels are just poor victims of feminism and not the perpetrators of it. Oh man, white woman would choose me over a chat from another nation, but they are somehow brainwashed by feminism and the media. They never blame white woman. When I see people like that, I know from the get-go that they are not really black-pilled. So we warned him that she would eventually cheat on him. And he got so offended. He started insulting us. No man, my girl ain't like that. What do you guys know about the relationships anyways? You never had a GF, bro. You just slept with this Asian female on the first date. What makes you think that she won't put out for other white men? The bottom line. Oh, we are not all incels here. Please don't think badly of us. You are gonna get a pat on the back, bro. So much for the black pill. I am trying to black pill your man.
And I know a lot of normies in the comment section are gonna say, oh man, I am Middle Eastern and I have no problem getting women.
I can already hear them typing viciously. And I know what people are gonna say. Oh man, you know, these are white respondents, you know. Of course they will prefer their own race. How this is even just be white. And the funny thing is, you'll have normies in the comments section saying, oh man, you are so wrong, I don't see it that way. Middle Eastern men are very attractive. It doesn't matter what you think, it doesn't change the reality. Oh, I don't see it that way. Yeah. Okay, you don't see it that way, but the evidence sees it that way. I know some of you guys are gonna say, oh, they should just go back. Times are changing, even in the Middle East. They say, dude, it is because you guys are patriarchal and macho. That is why nobody wants you. Stop being a victim. Oh man, we muddied the waters. It is not so easy anymore. The return on investment in Asia isn't so high anymore. It is time to try different countries. Oh, I am interested in Middle East culture. Oh, I am interested in Cambodian culture. Oh, Cambodian culture, man. I have never seen a culture like that. People often say, did you try getting a life approaching females? Some people say, oh, 100 years ago there was less hypergamy. Divorce rates were lower. This is the proof that it is just behavior and not nature. That is because females didn't get to choose back then. Oh, my wife always tells me he's just asexual, you know, and we haven't had sex in 5 years. And I just found out her colleagues are running a train on her. Fucking Brootl, bro. If you were to show them my videos, they would say, oh, this guy is so wrong, man. This guy is, you know, I am ugly and I have a wife. You incels are obsessed with looks. Meanwhile, his own wife didn't touch that garbage bag in the last decade. She's getting double teamed by Chad and Tyrone during weekends while he jerks off the porn. When I said the mug never stops, I wasn't joking. Like, you are thinking, thank God I wasn't born as a human. I was born as a crane, as a bird. Then you see this motherfucker dabbing on you, mugging you to the fifth dimension. You think just because you were born as a crane, you are in the clear. Wrong. Oh, feminism isn't cause of inceldom. That is factually wrong. Oh, there are online apps now, you know, online dating. It is easier to meet people if you just wanna fuck. Yeah, except the fact that only top 10% of good-looking men are hogging all the females from Tinder. Bro, you think average man gets any pussy from Tinder? Not a fucking chance. Oh, it is rough for ugly females, you know. You can only find meaningless sex. No, bitch, you could find a meaningful relationship if you went for a man in your own league.
The what community?
Incel community.
Oh, you incels are so obsessed with looks. Bro, humans are obsessed with looks. And I am sure, I am 100% sure this female would say, oh, dude, you incels are so obsessed with looks, you know, it's not about looks. But in his mind, he isn't thinking, oh, I am below her level. He's thinking, I am more established than her. I am more successful, I am assertive, I am intellectual, I am confident, all that generic, oh, I have what it takes to be a man stuff, you know. Oh, she tells me she likes me. Oh, she could have chosen the Chad light. Bro, she did choose Chad. She did choose Chad a long time ago. You just don't know it yet. Of course she's gonna say, oh baby, you know, I have had only two boyfriends before. Oh babe, I am not really into that stuff. Bro, she's not gonna give you the real number. He was saying shit like, oh, ITV, I am running just a white game, man. Weren't you saying just a white, I am running just a white game, just like you said, man. I can't believe this fucking guy, bro. These words are coming from a guy who would agree with the notion of, there is no female nature, bro. I might be ugly, but this girl says that she likes me. I have found one. Oh, there is no female nature, you know, it is just behavior. Bro, it is behavior stemming from nature. One is saying there is no female nature. Other one saying feminism doesn't create incels. Another one is saying this negative vibe is why you are incel, man. Females can't feel the darkness in you. I am watching these guys and I am like, the fuck are you talking about, bro? Oh, females can't feel the darkness, the bad vibes of you. Of course you are not gonna get any females. Is she free to just walk away and leave me with nothing? I can't believe this guy. You are thinking, well, I will just approach the uglier ones. Yeah,
about that. Never listen to people. They will say, oh, just find someone with same interests, somewhat you are compatible with. Your looks is your compatibility. Let me say it again for the guys in the back. Your looks is your compatibility. This whole sub is filled with posts like, oh, why do I attract creeps? Or the other ones are complaining that men they were messaging to on Tinder turned out to be catfish. One of the things I get often is snarky comments about me being in sub. They don't comment on why I am wrong or where my point fails. It is always about my channel name. Oh, you don't have a GF. You don't get to talk about females, or, you know, you don't have any experience. How can you know about female nature? These people think they are being smart when they bring this up. Oh, look at this pictures of Indian men with white females. This is the proof that Indian men have higher SMV than white men. Bro, outlier examples will never debunk the black pill. Or similarly, they say, you know, oh, what about K-pop? Bro, average Asian guy looks nothing like those K-pop stars. Another thing they always do is that, oh, it is because of the media. I have addressed this multiple times in the past as well. And then people are gonna tell us, oh, you don't have any experience, you can't know any better. And where did EDP's experience take you? Normies always tell us, oh, stop whining, stop complaining. I feel like we are not complaining enough. And people are gonna tell us, oh, don't complain, man. Don't complain. I feel like I am not complaining enough. And we get told, don't complain, man. Those people ain't about this life, man, I am telling you. People telling us, oh, you're complaining about female too much, man. You put women on pedestal. They wouldn't last in our position. Oh, I actually like, you know, 5'5 Asian and Indian guys. It just so happens my boyfriend is white and 6'3. People who keep telling us, oh, you gotta keep getting better, you gotta be funny, you gotta have 10 out of 10 personality, you gotta get your money right, you gotta have a purpose, approach 5 women a day, date 10 women at the same time, build confidence, cure cancer, turn yourself into Thanos, collect all the infinite stones. They are the ones putting women on a pedestal. AMS, I have read all your books, man. I have self-improved. I am top of my class. I have mastered several martial arts. I have learned game. My game's on point. I have abundance mindset, but I am still not getting anything. And look at the responses these people get. And I know some normies say, well, of course, Chad and Tyrone don't need to self-improve, but for normies, it can work. You gotta self-improve. But even then, I don't see how purpose, cool hobbies, and interests will help much if the attraction, physical attraction, isn't there. You are gonna say, oh, I am done with the black pill. Yeah, but it is not done with you. Not quite. And I know what you are gonna say. I can already hear you typing. Oh man, I don't need any social skills anyway. I'm gonna just keep my head down and study. Guys, I would hate to end your last bit of corpse, but I gotta tell you this. It isn't about what you know, it is about who you know. People always ask, what do you suggest them? What is the solution? I am telling you the solution. This is one of the solutions I have in mind.
Oh, I am done, I believe. Bro, like, leave. Leave. Best of luck. You're gonna need it. And then you have Jester Maxers and Dumpster Divers. Oh, I got a GF. I proved you guys wrong. You didn't prove anyone wrong. I get this snarky comment all the time from fake sales. How can you know about females so much, man? For someone who never had a GF, it is amazing how much you know. These guys have a nerve, man. Look, if you want a dumpster dive, that is your choice. You do you. I am not gonna hold it against you. But then they are like, oh, my girl ain't like that, man. You don't get to color that. Don't ever color that word. I will color whatever I want. By the way, to those of you who dropped comments like, how is this even JVW, man? This has nothing to do with JVW in my last video. They were saying how Cameron Heron's case is not JVW. Bro, JVW definitely played a role. I didn't say it is all JVW, but it definitely played a role. To all of you who dropped comments like, wait, man, how is this even JVW? The guy is good looking. Do you really think those females would have even heard about Cameron if he was some swarthy ethnic guy? A simple question I am asking you. You get gaslighted by females. Oh, ITV, don't feel bad, sweetie. I am 5'2 myself and I made it in life. I didn't let my height hold me back. My husband just happens to be 6'3. These people have lost their touch with reality, man. I mean, we get this normal line a lot too. ITV, don't feel bad, man. You just dodged a bullet, man. You gotta think I must be a professional bullet dodger at this point.
Oh, hey guys, I am 5'2 Indian guy. I am finally not an asshole, even though I have yet to hold a female's hand. Can I please get a pat on the back for being a spineless pushover? Hey guys, I am not an inkwell anymore, finally at age 28. Even though I still haven't even been on a date yet. Oh, IT, but I have a girlfriend. Black pill is bullshit. What do I always say? What do I always say? You guys always ask me, bro, what can be worse than being an incel? This. You don't want to be this in life. Whenever people make snarky comments like, ITV, you never had a GF. How can you know about females? I have experience. I always imagine them as this guy. Imagine you are beating up someone. And all it takes is, did you mean any harm? You say, no man, it was an act of love. I was showing her my passion. Okay sir, you are free to go. It is as easy as this. If JBW is real, then how come I am an incel? Bro, you live in 95% white city. Of course you ain't seen JBW, everybody is white. Instead of, oh, I'm gonna go MGTOW man, or turn into those PUA clowns. And I know what you'll say. You'll say, oh, he's a Chad, I am nothing like him. Okay, I admit, he's good looking. Some specialize in Latin America, some specialize in Middle East, under the disguise of, oh, I've become a Muslim bullshit. Some specialize in Southeast Asia under the disguise of culture. Oh man, Thai culture, man. I ain't never seen a culture like that. No, man, our relationship ain't like that, man. She doesn't see me as subhuman. Bro, wake up. Wake the fuck up. Oh, she doesn't see me that way. You are just jealous. Says the guy who had to go to fucking Southeast Asian jungles to get a piece of ass and lose his virginity. You are just jealous, man. You never had a GF. It is always funny how they get so smug because they got laid. And they act like we can't possibly know any better.
That's just by chance. I don't have any preferences as to who I date. That's just how life works.
It just so happens, guys. Literally every single ethnic girl dating out. Oh, it just so happens, sweetie. Like fucking clockwork, man. Oh, I had a wife 20 years ago. I am not an incel. Bro, nobody gives a shit. Oh, you need to be assertive. You need to have confidence. She is telling you that, and I am telling you to not be confident unless you are a good looking guy. Oh, just change who you are. They don't understand. And then, oh, you are recruiting. Bro, I don't have to recruit shit.
The same motherfucker who says, oh, you incels are delusional, man. I am a Chad and I have got a wife. Meanwhile, his own wife doesn't want to touch that garbage bag. In her mind, she was going to transition into a man, drinking beer, watching football. She was going to be like, yo, yo, bitches, bitches, yo, yo. And life was going to work out just like that. Oh, what do I do? Does anyone know what I can do? Subscribe to the fucking channel, brother. So you get a notification next time I fucking upload. That is what you do at that point.
Left-wing leftist females will say, oh yeah man, you know, crying and showing emotions doesn't make you less of a man. It doesn't make you weak, it makes you more of a man. But trust and believe when I say this. You do that, if you do that in their presence, that feminist pussy is gonna dry up harder than the freaking Serengeti.
And I know what you're gonna say. You're gonna say, oh man, how do you know he was an incel? Maybe he was a normie. He might have been married. Oh, let me tell you why Chads are offering themselves. Oh, you see, with struggles, you appreciate life more. Chads are living unfulfilling lives and then committing suicide later. I mean, this is such a common cop.
Oh bro, don't look at that 6'3 blonde chat blasting the back wall of that Muslim girl you had a crush on for years. Those guys are just committing zina. They will burn in hellfire.
ITB, don't worry about it, brother. Even though you will have to import a girl from your home country to be able to hold a female's hand, it is not about how you live in this life, brother. You will go to heaven, ITB.
Oh, ITB, this shows that that girl is a sinner willing to commit zina. This is good for you, brother. And I know what you're gonna say. Oh my god, he's talking about just before I take it. Oh my fucking god. Where is Mr. Face on BBC? We miss him already. InkwellTV, we are tired of your bitch ass.
then you have red pill manosphere coppers telling you, oh man, females are incapable of love. Even the chat is being used for his money. Brother, they are not capable of loving you. And no amount of money or muscle or fucking game can buy you that kind of love.
You always say, oh, what is the benefit of the black pill? The benefit of the black pill is this. You don't want to be this in life. These guys are fucking finished. First, now they are in dead bedrooms. A couple years down the line, these motherfuckers are gonna post on divorce subreddit. Then their latest destination is the MGTOW community. Oh, I have decided to go MGTOW. When they were incel all along. You know, normies are gonna gaslight you. Oh bro, you just gotta graduate from med school. Oh, man peak at their 50s, bro. Oh, you just need to get your shit together and you are gonna get females. Oh, you just need to step up and be a real man. What they really mean is go become a beta box for a mediocre female. Oh, I think it may be over, brother. It was over a long fucking time ago. These are truly broken men. And I know all top views are down. And some guys are gonna be like, who the fuck are you calling broken man? You are a fucking incel. I would rather be in my situation than these guys. Another incel in denial. And I love how I know these cretins would be offended if you called them incel to their faces. Oh my god, I'm not fucking incel like you. I respect women. I respect women 24/7. I'm respecting them right now. I'm a full-time woman respecter. Or they say, oh, I am married, dude. I am not an incel. Meanwhile, his own wife doesn't want to touch that garbage bag. How is it fucking possible for a man to be this blue-pilled? Oh, she just happened. She just happened to develop some weird condition right after the marriage. Oh, I haven't been able to identify the cows. I love how they all use the soy boy terminology as well.
You guys always ask, what is the benefit of the black pill?
Oh, ITV, you don't offer any solutions, man.
I am offering solutions to your future self. Sometimes I am listening to incels in the community and some say, oh bro, I am a self-improve. I will go to gym and get a six-pack. I will learn 4 fucking languages, get my STEM degree, become an executive in a Fortune 500 company. After work during nights, I will study finance and learn to invest. I will travel to Warmer and collect the Soul Stone. And I am like, damn, that is one hell of a roadmap, man. Looks like you got it all figured out for the next 10 years of your life. Then what? After all that shit, what are you gonna do then? And they are like, ITV, what do you mean, bro? Then I will finally get some ass. I will finally get a girlfriend, bro. All that cringe maxing shit. Just to get cocked by some pizza eating, Xbox playing, 6'4 chat.
Oh, I had a wife 37 years ago, bro. I am not an incel like you. Nobody fucking cares. Your effective SMV is still lower than the majority of self-identified incels. Oh, I have experience. You have bad experience. Yes, you have experience, but it is bad experience. Oh, they are going to go to hell because they don't believe in our religion. And we are going to go to heaven for putting up with this bullshit. Or they say, oh, this is a test, bro. God is testing you. It is funny how some people's test is elementary school math, while some people's is advanced calculus. And yet everybody is held to the same standards. Funny how that works. Just be a good boy, keep putting up with this, and you will get rewarded in afterlife. It's God's will, bro. This is just a test. I remember I had this one copper in school tell me, oh, ITV, the chick you had a crush on since middle school is getting railed by that blonde chat. That means she is willing to commit zina. She's not a real believer, bro. This is good. This is very good for you. God is doing a favor by showing you her true face, man. You are the real winner in this situation. Dude, I swear I am a fucking punch your dumbass face. I am already butthurt about the whole situation, and on top of that, I have to listen to this retarded copper annoying me even more. Like, rubbing it in. Oh, ITV, man, that dish you are eating has pork in it, you know that, right? Just leave me the fuck alone, man. Please, please go your own way. Please go MGTOW. Please go MGTOW, bro. Oh, bro, look, females are going crazy because we are going MGTOW. Oh, I will go my own way. This will show females. Meanwhile, females are just glad that you removed yourself from their purview. Oh, you won't have a loving husband when you are 30. Says the guy telling men to go MGTOW and not get married. Oh, when she hits the wall, bro, it will be all over for her. Please, man, please just stop. And you have missed out community coping. Oh, she won't have a loving partner when she's 40. The cop is both sad and funny. I mean, it really is. Oh, bro, in reality, she is miserable, bro. You see, she has to suck 1,000 dicks. And in 5 years, she will go crazy because MGTOW community won't want her then. Stay MGTOW, gents. Oh, females are going crazy. They are losing their minds because we are going MGTOW. Bro, they don't fucking care. Oh, I will go my own way. I will do it. I swear I will do it. Don't push me. I will do it. You will see then. Oh, you thought he would tolerate being friend-zoned. Treated like shit. You put him in the friend zone, you cocked him, you traded him terribly. Now you are crying cause he has gone MGTOW.
Normies were like, oh, dude, go touch some grass. But when Andrew Tate says exactly what I said years ago, oh my god, Mr. Tate, please take my money, sir. Tate says, what chance the guy working at Target in Montana stands? Oh, anything is possible. You can do it. You can do anything. No, you cannot do anything in life. And it is not your fault. Oh, you don't offer any solutions. There are a lot of solutions in my videos, actually. Oh, ITV, why don't you talk about Lux Maxim more? Because I firmly believe that there is a limit to how much you can improve with soft Lux Maxim. No prostitution and escort Maxim. Oh, none of these problems exist, bro. If you have 50 bucks, just go see a hooker. And I know what some of you are gonna say.
ITV, I don't know about that, man. Race mixing is wrong, bro. We should stick to our own race, man.
Fuck that shit. You will see people claiming, oh, I have figured it out, man. Buy my program for 600 bucks and I will tell you my secrets and all the solutions. Oh, is it really worth $400? Guys, this guy paid 400. To be told it is over. If the doctor bullshitted him, oh bro, men peak at their 50s, bro. Your best years lie ahead of you. Women find 60 years old men hotter anyway, bro. He would have given him another 400.
No.